Everyone, welcome to another Power Talk with Archana. This is your platform to reach out to the stars. Plan your success with me, Archana, as I lead you, inspire you, support you, and mentor you to unleash your passions and expertise. Coach you, mentor you to achieve your success goals, and help you carve your dream life you've always dreamt for. Power Talk with Archana brings to you world-class virtual and in-person skill development programs, especially curated for you. We support you all through as you take your first step launching your startup initiative. Welcome to my world as I collaborate with business leaders from across the world. Let's welcome one such business leader today, Atul Moga. Atul is a part of my professional network and based in Gurugram, India. Atul is the guy who knows the in and out of partnerships and strategic alliances. He has served as the Vice President Affiliates and Partnerships at PolicyBazaar.com. He has been an angel investor himself, and now he has launched his own startup called Basic. So if you have woken up with a bright, promising idea and are on your way to launch your startup, this episode of Power Talk with Archana is for you. So let's give a very warm welcome to our dear friend, Atul Moga. Hello, Atul. How are you doing today?
Hi, Archana. I'm fine. And thanks for the kind introduction.
Very happy to have you with us, Atul. Atul, we know you have always been into strategic partnerships, alliances. That has been your forte all through. In fact, that is what you have been doing at PolicyBazaar.com too. But from a well-paying job to a startup, how did this all start? I would want you to tell my audience, from the time you started actually conceptualizing your startup to the day you launched it, how many months, what is the kind of preparation, you know, everything that went into doing what you're doing today?
The idea of Basic is around affordable housing loans. So I've been working in mortgage industry from past 5-6 years. And, you know, as a business head with various organizations, and I've seen, you know, while working with various banks, that most of the banks currently focus on big ticket loans. Affordable, although being a priority sector lending in India, banks generally, you know, don't think too much about it because banks need to do big volumes and that their revenues is as a percentage of the ticket size of the loan. So their costs are fixed. They have to invest the same amount of money for a small ticket loan or a big ticket loan. So what happens is that their focus is earning more revenues and they do big ticket. And so over a period of these 5 years, I've always seen that affordable housing segment, although being promoted by government, you must have seen PM Modi speaking about housing for all, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Still, you know, if you go to tier 2, tier 3 cities, you will see people don't have too many options. Around 60% of lending in India is done in Mumbai, or you can say Maharashtra and Delhi, and remaining India only have 40% of the share. So this means there is some problem that people, you know, banks are not able to reach out to people in tier 2, tier 3 cities. So that's how, so this idea was with me from, you know, a couple of years, but it took some time for from my end, you know, to know about the market, to talk to people, to understand whether it is something to be, to be worthwhile doing. So what I realized was that the key problem is the branch network, that banks don't have it in the remote locations or in, you know, tier 2, tier 3 cities. So this problem can be solved using technology, that if you have some kind of a mobile platform or maybe an internet platform, because currently, you know, mobile is everywhere. Everyone has a smartphone. So using these, you know, simple technologies, using apps, you can reach to the customer, not through a branch, but maybe through an app. So that's the genesis of Basic. It was with me from a long time. Then, you know, it took me some time also to take the plunge because I was talking to people about it. I always discussed that, can this be a viable business model? And this year, when I met some other people, my investors also, they also showed interest in it. So Pyches Capital, who have invested in our company as a seed investor, I discussed the idea with those guys and they were very excited about it. And when they also supported me and they were ready to put their money in it, I thought that this is the right time to do it. And that's how I started my company.
Lovely. So Atul, I clearly understand from what you just told me that planning is really important. You conceptualized the idea of BASIC almost 5 years back, and you just kind of kept working on it. So when it comes about, you know, working on a startup, I think pitch is very important. You need to understand how important the pitch is for the investor to know what exactly the business model is going to be, what are the kind of return on investments they expect, and whether you would want their expertise as a part of the investment or not. So what are your thoughts? How did you create that pitch? And what do you think is the most important ingredient in any pitch for any investor to invest in that startup?
Okay, so regarding pitch, see, I have given pitches to many people, and over a period of time, whenever I discussed this idea, some have even ridiculed it. So, you know, I remember talking to someone that people are doing a lot of business loans and personal loans in fintech. Why not affordable housing loans? It's about the same ticket size. You know, so I have even heard that it's not possible. Why don't you make a simple product? So I have seen rejections, but then you have to present your business plan in a way that it becomes, you know, important for the VC or investor. See, the thing is, an investor will invest in two kind of companies. One, the company which can be profitable very soon, and it's a standard business, but you're doing it differently. Or an idea which is disruptive, which might take some time to come up to profitability, but they are ready to back you because it's going to give a long-term return. So you have to pitch accordingly. Like my idea, home loans are done by everyone. Means there are so many HFCs in India. If you go to National Housing Board of India website, you will see, you know, hundreds of HFCs in India were present. But still the problem remains. Home loans are only 10% of GDP in India. Whereas if you see developed markets of US or UK, it's 60%. Even China is 30%. Even though we have so many lenders, there is demand because the penetration is low. Still, you know, people are not getting loans. Means, have you seen it in any industry that there is supply, there is demand, but people are not getting matched? So what so that's what I presented to my investor, that yes, I know there are many lenders for home loans. Yes, I know there is a huge demand. So I'm not trying to be either of those. I'm trying to be a platform which can match those guys and to bring efficiencies. Now you gave a new perspective to someone. Now people were receptive, and then I, you know, explained more about the technologies we are building, how we're going to create the book, how we're going to penetrate into the, you know, rural market or tier two market. That's what they excited to them, and that's how I secured funding for my company.
Lovely. I think that's a brilliant, brilliant way of, you know, approaching the entire concept. Lovely, Atul. Atul, tell me one thing. For any guy who wants to venture into a startup, has a brilliant idea, do you think it's only about that idea, about that great pitch, or you think there is something beyond that that really helps the ball rolling, you know? I mean, something that really drives the entire business plan. Do you think there's anything else beyond that idea?
See, it's my personal view, and I might be wrong, that, you know, we say that there are two kind of people, doers and thinkers. I believe doers are more tend to be successful in the startup world. So that's why when we hire people in our company, the first question we ask to them is, we don't care that what sector you have worked in. We don't care what, you know, qualifications you have. Can you execute? So execution is the key. Many people will have startup ideas. Means same idea can be done by 10 people. But the thing which matters is execution. How fast you can execute, how better you can execute. So I believe execution is the key. Because, you know, ideas, anyone can dream of ideas. Anyone can think of ideas. Problems are everywhere. And anyone can think of those problems. But now the key lies in the execution. So I believe a person who is focused, and most importantly, discipline, that he has a plan, he or she has a plan to implement. That's matter the more. And finally, the most important thing, keeping stop losses. Because people generally, you know, tend to get carried away with one thing. They zone into one idea, or, you know, they just venture into one thing. You need to have a stop loss that I will do it, or maybe any sub function of your idea, that I will do this strategy up to this time, and after that I need to change the strategy. So this kind of simple execution focus points are, I believe, is the key to success for any company. And again, it's my perspective and what I have learned in my life. People might do things differently.
No, I completely agree with what you've said. It's really, really the most valid, two very valid points that you have raised. It's very important to have that passion, and you should be able to execute your plans the right way. If the execution is going in the right direction and you have the art and the ability to revisit your plans off and on, you will definitely make it big and have the right team on board who can help you execute your plans the right way. And you, as you very rightly said, it's very important to build that energy in your team to let that ball go places. And of course, you should be very well aware of the fact that you cannot go beyond a certain point. You need to lower your level and then work on it. You just cannot get your company into losses. You need to draw the line. Very right. Amazing. Great, Atul. Atul, so tell us one thing. We know we have so many players in this industry. So why the focus of your business on home loans and that to affordable housing segment?
Okay, so yeah, there are many players in the fintech industry and especially in the lending industry, but if you see, most of them are focused on unsecured loans, which is solving the problem of personal loans or business loans. Affordable housing player, you will find very less people, and very less people who are doing it into tier 2, tier 3 cities. So I believe it's a wide space, and it is something where people can have first mover advantage, and then it is something which is very dear to everyone. It's housing. It's the basic necessity of anyone. So, this is a problem for all. From, poor people to rich people, everyone need a house. But we focus on affordable because I believe in India, big ticket home loans, as I explained earlier, has a lot of options to be done through the banks. Whereas affordable housing, especially in, again, I'll, repeat those words, tier 2, tier 3 cities, rural segments, there people need lenders. People need more efficient technologies. It's not that, they don't know how to use technology. It's not that there is no demand. It's just you have to redirect the supply over there. So that's the reason I've been focused on affordable housing loans currently. And currently we are sourcing for other banks, and we have plans to become our own lender. Once we have our distribution set up in these cities, we can easily set up a credit, which can be, done through mobile app without a branch. So that's what the plans are. So I believe it's a big problem which we're trying to solve, and it in itself is a big problem, a big market. So we can focus and we can provide, a focused approach to this, which can help us in solving it efficiently.
Quite right there. I think there is a big gap there, and I think your efforts are definitely going to bridge this gap. It's all about, making sure that, needs are met. And if it is being unanswered, then this is the right time to plunge into it. Amazing. So tell me, do you really see a change in the lending ecosystem in the post-COVID scenario, the VUCA world that we are in?
VUCA world is a... Okay. So yeah, definitely, before COVID also, for most of the unsecured loans, a lot of new players were coming. They were, digitizing the overall process flow. And I believe after COVID, it will expedite. So personal loan, business loan in next couple of years will become completely online. That was again one of the points. We didn't do other kind of loans. We did only home loans, because I believe personal loan and business loan will become automated. And there are so many players in the market already for that. But home loans, what happens in home loans is that we are not only analyzing the profile of the customer, we are also analyzing the profile of the property. So there, although there will be automation, there will be technology, but a major part of the process is going to remain offline. And there, my thinking is that if you cannot digitize, there will be an attempt to automate it. Like I'll give you an example of Swiggy. You order online, but the fulfillment is in offline. Same thing we are doing. We ask customer to come online, give the requirement, my agent go to customer, and then do end-to-end fulfillment offline using a mobile app where you have tracking. That's a simple thing we are doing. So there will be a shift in lending. In unsecured loans, definitely they are going to move much faster into online domain. But in terms of secured loans, especially in home loans, automation technologies will come, but full digitization might take a while. And again, one more factor is that India lacks a central property database. So you cannot verify a property through that database, like you have in, Western countries, that if I have to take a loan, I'll just put the details of the property and get details. And we don't have it in India. So till those databases are not there, property, management things are not there, there will be offline lag remaining. And there we believe we have advantage as compared to others.
Lovely, amazing. Great, Atul. Atul, going back to the startups again, is there anything that you would like to advise the people who want to plunge into a startup or have a bright idea? Anything, any warning signs you would like to give them?
Warning, not, I guess, means if a person has an idea, first thing I'll suggest him is talk to people. Because many a times when you start and then you realize, okay, I've done it wrong, then there is no, you know, coming back out of it. So talk to people, talk to your advisors. These days, you know, startup ecosystem in India is so much developed that you can approach any, you know, investor or any person who is mentoring startups very easily. And people are happy to help you. I got a lot of help from a lot of people. And, you know, they actually helped me in making my idea in a better way. And I was able to, I mean, there are many things which I started or planned in the beginning, which we are not doing currently. It's just because of the feedback. Feedback matters a lot. And finally, I'll say, you know, fortune favors the bold. Just do it. You know, if you are, you know, doing it rightly, putting your heart into it, you will land up somewhere. Definitely something good gonna come out of it.
Lovely, amazing. Thank you so much, Atul. Thanks a lot for speaking to my audience. I'm sure they're going to love this conversation and really, really benefit out of this conversation. Thank you so much, and we wish you all the best for your startup. I hope you really make it big and live your dream. Thanks a lot for coming on board.
Thanks for having me here, and it was nice speaking to you, and hopefully I was able to convince or convey my message to you what we are trying to do in home loans ecosystem, and maybe someone can find my my statements encouraging enough to start something of their own.
Thank you so much, Atul. Have a wonderful life. Bye-bye. That was Atul Monga for you. I hope you took notes of all the do's and don'ts before you plunge into your dream startup. Stay inspired, stay focused, and keep working on your dreams. I wish all of you the very best. Until then, stay tuned for more.